Master coaches Des Hasler and Craig Bellamy have begun the mind games ahead of their huge showdown tomorrow night. Hasler says Melbourne could be impossible to beat in coming weeks, while Bellamy has put the pressure on Manly's Tom Trbojevic to reach a new level in the semis.
Manly have lost their last four matches to Melbourne. Des Hasler knows things won't get any easier tomorrow.
Maybe Melbourne are impossible to beat. So, have to wait and see.
Des might be just playing a couple of games there and try and get our boys a bit overconfident.
Craig Bellamy is happy to play his own games, heaping pressure on Sea Eagles superstar Tom Trbojevic to go above and beyond the incredible football he's already playing.
I'd imagine it's going to be another level tomorrow night, the situation of the game is, and you know, he's had plenty of games back now.
Hasler confident his fullback won't be rattled.
He carries himself so well, presents both himself, his family and his club so well, deserves everything that's coming his way.
Bellamy believes his own number one is ready to explode in the finals. Ryan Pappenhausen scored a hat-trick last week, recapturing his fitness and confidence after a long concussion layoff.
He's had three starting games now, so, you know, he should be getting back, you know, his peak.
Cameron Munster is firming to play. A final decision on his infected knee will be left up to him.
Doesn't look like it's hindering him at all, but, you know, he's just got to make that decision on how it feels.
Luke Duffesy, Nine News.
Foul play has played a big part in the season of Parramatta's Ryan Madison. He's been on the receiving end of it, and he was suspended for dishing out some of his own. But Madison returns this week for the Eels' sudden-death showdown with Newcastle.
It's been a long 3 weeks for Ryan Madison, watching from the sidelines suspended after being sent off for this nasty shoulder charge.
It was a fast play, the ball, and I just leant in, and it was one of those things that happens that quick, Emma, that you can't really do much besides say sorry. I'm only human, and the game's that fast, and I've got a lot of remorse for what I've done, and I'm just glad Brad's okay playing some good footy.
Madison's been on the other end of it too. 5 weeks out because of this shot from Felice Kafusi in round two. The only difference is the Melbourne forward was reluctant to apologise.
I felt sorry for him because I know what it feels like to be on the other end of it. And there's a lot of tackles that's gone like that this year. I don't know the speed of the game or whatnot, but you just can't help to say sorry.
Madison avoids social media commentary, but he does feel for Latrell Mitchell. The Bunnies star has copped some heavy backlash and even death threats after breaking Joey Manu's cheekbone.
I saw Latrell the other day, and he was in high spirits. But like I said, I don't think that there's not an NRL player that goes out there wanting to actually hurt somebody. So if people are thinking that, well, then they're totally wrong. We wear our hearts on our sleeves and we want to do the best for the jersey that we wear, and comes with aggression, and it's a contact sport, and something is bound to go wrong.
Emma Lawrence, Nine News.
If the West Tigers board sacks coach Michael Maguire, it will be going against the wishes of the players. That is the strong belief of Tigers captain James Tarmo, who says it would be senseless to punt Maguire now, despite another wasted season.
The never-ending stories about Michael Maguire being a dead man walking have earned the ire of the top Tiger, skipper James Tarmo.
So, James, does Madge still have the Tigers dressing room?
100%. I haven't seen anything like it. Every word he says, everyone still hangs on the balance. I was talking to the players. Before we left, we all sort of said the same thing about Madge. So, you know, we like I said, I haven't had too much to do with the board, but they know where we are at.
Is it time to change coaches?
No, I don't think so, mate. I don't think so at all.
James, if he was sacked as coach, how would that impact you?
It'll be tough. It'll be like losing a friend. I don't see the sense. Like I said, you need these things. It takes time. You need the cohesion. And to bring someone else and to start again, you know, you're just sort of starting again. Madge has laid a foundation.
Tarmo says he knows he's been wearing heat for not being a vocal leader. He's already taking steps to fix that.
I don't want another season like this season, and I know no one else in that club does. It hurts. We're all hurt. So, you know, I messaged some boys, you know, come back in pretty good shape because we're hitting the ground running.
And one thing he's sure of, Luke Brooks is part of the Tigers' solution, not the problem.
Would you like Brooksy to stay, mate?
Absolutely, mate. Absolutely. I trust Brooksy.
On the Sunshine Coast, Danny Widler, Nine News.